The Socioeconomic Planning Agency publishes a new five-year Philippine Development Plan, which contains some insights on the state of the country's aviation infrastructure. ABS-CBN correspondent Warren De Guzman with the details.
The Philippine Development Plan 2023-2028 lists improving connectivity through better infrastructure as one of its main strategies to growing the economy, and it was published on the first day of 2023. What it says about the current state of that infrastructure is not encouraging at all. The 12th chapter on expanding and upgrading infrastructure, PDP 2023-2028, noted that plans to improve airport infrastructure had stalled over the last few years, and I quote, "Little progress has been made to improve airport infrastructure. The country only has a total of 90 airports in operation, comprising 11 international, 41 domestic, 38 community, and 3 airports not in operation in 2022. However, not all the country's international airports and Principal Class 1 and Principal Class 2 airports comply with modern safety design thresholds, particularly the minimum runway strip threshold, width, and night landing capabilities. Proposed improvements to major gateways in the country were put on hold and are being reassessed to consider new projections in aviation demand, travel limitations, lockdowns, and hampered business operations due to the COVID-19 pandemic caused a decline in passenger traffic by 33.47% from 2020 to 2021. And over the same period, air traffic movement likewise decreased by 54.7%. The plan also noted that airport capacities will not likely be able to keep up with demand. It said, I quote, "Air traffic congestion is likely to persist, if not worsen, without the needed investments in developing, upgrading, and improving airports. Airport capacities in 2022 will be inadequate to cater to domestic and international aviation demand, which is expected to recover by 2025. Aggravating the congestion in many domestic airports is their lack of night landing capabilities. Meanwhile, the expansion of some existing airports may not be technically and or financially feasible," end quote. To rectify the issue, the government is planning to mobilize foreign and private capital and possibly packaging some of those airports and the modernization of those airports in public-private partnerships. Now, the PDP 2023-2028 is meant to outline specific goals and targets for the Philippine economy throughout the Marcos administration. In terms of travelers, it expects the number of both air and sea travelers to increase considerably in every year following 2022, which was only at 35.72 million total passengers. The PDP 2023-2028 plan does not have targets yet for tourism's contribution to GDP. That is expected to be completed in the first quarter of 2023. And in 2021, tourism's contribution to GDP was 5.2%.
The travel nightmare on New Year's Day also haunted some 3,000 passengers at the Iloilo Airport. For many stranded passengers, the next challenge is getting on the next available flights. ABS-CBN correspondent Bianca Dava joins us on the line for more details. Bianca?
Denise, around 3,000 passengers were stranded at the Iloilo International Airport on New Year's Day. Flights from and to the airport in Cabatuan town were canceled after flight operations at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport had been put on hold on the first day of 2023. Data from airline companies showed that 806 passengers of Philippine Airlines, 1,399 passengers of Cebu Pacific, and 498 passengers of AirAsia were affected by the flight cancellation. We've talked to one of the stranded passengers here in Iloilo, Noel Pahutagana. Noel, his wife, and two children were supposed to fly back to Manila on Sunday evening after the Christmas and New Year break. But he said they only knew of their canceled flight while on their way to the airport. They did not receive any text message or email from their airline. Noel said they were greeted at the airport by long queues of disappointed passengers hoping to have their flights rebooked. Pictures sent by Bayan Patroller Van Ayan Huada to ABS-CBN News also showed chaotic scenes at check-in counters. Noel explained they were hoping to return to Manila before January 4th when they were required to physically report to work. However, the earliest available flight that they got for rebooking was also on the same date. Now today, January 2, some Philippine Airline and AirAsia flights to and from Iloilo already resumed, but several Cebu Pacific flights remain canceled. A video taken by Bayan Patroller Ed Raymond Haen this morning showed frustrated and tired passengers lining up and waiting at check-in counters to get clarification and early flights out. Now, in a statement, the Department of Tourism Western Visayas advised passengers to coordinate with their respective airlines on the status of their flights, as technical issues on the navigational air traffic management of CAAP hampered air travel all over the country. Reporting from Iloilo, Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks, Bianca.